Anyway, maybe this is more fuel to the fire as far as your interpretation of Facebook, but Zuckerberg wants his employees to be referred to as metamates, putting their ship and crew before themselves. Mm. They're going all aboard the metaship.
Choo-choo?
The Mediterranean.
Oh, the Mediterranean.
Yeah. Whichever you want. I said metaship because it says ship there. I mean, I don't know what it's like to work inside of one of these big corporate environments, but I would assume it's difficult to have those vast number of people on the same page. And whenever I visit these places, because I have visited places, you get this immediate sense of, oh, this is something different from what I'm used to. Mm. There is a different energy here, a type of energy that I presume is somewhat necessary in order to organize the sheer number of individuals. And this maybe is something you could say for corporate environments or any environment in which on a daily basis, it's meant to facilitate the interactions of thousands of people. That there's something that just happens at scale. I mean, even when you went to high school, it's there's something unnatural about that experience that you're cast into this thing, whatever. You probably went in grade 9 and then you walk in this building and all of a sudden, instead of being one of a couple hundred, you're one of a couple thousand. Mm. And so things change for you, your significance, your role, your relationships and so forth. Or take this company, for example. I mean, we talk to the entire, all of us talk to the entire company every single day. Mm. At Facebook, or Google or Apple or whatever, you start to sniff out this corporate culture. And it's one of the only ways to have cohesion amongst these enormous numbers of people. But it can also go completely overboard. It can also be terrifying and cult-like, especially when you start naming me something like a metamate, in which case I am running for the door, in which case I am out the door already. Mm. Call me a metamate, I get a certain feeling.
That's when you draw the line?
Yeah, I get a certain feeling.
Yeah.
That there's some persuasion taking place or that I'm meant to shed my own identity along the way to a certain extent. Mm-hmm. Or my own ability to think straight. I'm like, why do you have to call me anything? Mm-hmm. But of course, when you change your entire company name and your entire approach and the variety of products, then you're looking to have everybody on board. And so you start to come up with some crazy ideas. The CEO of Meta, formerly known as Facebook, said in a post on his Facebook page, he had told employees in a virtual all-hands meeting that he wanted the workforce to adopt a new motto, Meta, Metamates, Me. Metamates Me is about being good stewards of our company and mission. It's about the sense of responsibility we have for our collective success to each other as teammates. It's about taking care of our company and each other. It refers to the naval ship, shipmates, self, which Meta's chief technology officer said was something Instagram had been using for a while internally. It's long been discussed in the business organizational circles as a way to increase efficiency. You tell me, individuals of the world, those that are watching this, whether you're watching this live or after the fact, you tell me if you feel comfortable, if you would embrace the title of metamate granted upon you via Mr. Zuckerberg himself. Is this a thing that you would wear proudly, or is this a thing that you would run for the door, much like myself? I'm curious. Mm-hmm. I want to know what you think.